Hey guys, in this video we're going to break down the mechanism for a reaction called the Hofmann rearrangement. So guys, the Hofmann rearrangement is also known as the Hofmann degradation. So if you hear that term, just consider it synonymous with Hofmann rearrangement. And it's a method to turn amides into primary amines. Now guys, I do want to let you guys know that this is similar to another mechanism that you may or may not know at this point called the Curtius rearrangement. So I'm just going to put here, it's similar to Curtius rearrangement, okay? So just letting you know, if you are, you know, if you have seen that, my video on that reaction, or if you've learned about it already, this mechanism is going to remind you a whole lot of that one, okay? They're kind of similar. Now, if you don't know that reaction yet, it's fine, because I'm going to teach you the mechanism anyway, so you don't need to know the Curtius to understand this reaction, okay? But similar to Curtius, there's going to be two really similar things here, which is that this is a reaction that goes through an isocyanate intermediate. Okay. Now, I use the term intermediate here very precautiously because I don't like to say intermediate. It actually sounds like it's got a charge or that it's like a highly energized species. Isocyanate's pretty stable. I'm just saying it's like an intermediary structure where we make the isocyanate first and then we add something to it. Okay, so let's just, you know, make sure that we're clear on that. And then also similar to Curtius, it's gonna liberate CO2 gas as a byproduct, okay? But other than that, it's a mechanism all on its own, okay? So guys, here's the general reaction. We've got an amide. And you react it with two different steps. One is you have a base, okay? So you have some kind of base that's gonna deprotonate the nitrogen, turn it into a nucleophile, and we've got an electrophilic Br2, okay? The Br2 is gonna be what the nitrogen then attacks, okay? After you're able to add one equivalent of the bromine, what we're gonna see is a rearrangement take place and a decarboxylation that's gonna produce our gas, or CO2 gas, and the part we really care about, the amine. Now notice that one thing that happens here, just talking in general terms, is that the R group that was originally on one side of the carbonyl eventually gets attached directly to the N. So notice that before I had them separated by a carbon, and now I have them directly attached to each other. That's because I'm able to get rid of the carbonyl in the middle through my decarboxylation that you're going to see later, okay? So now in the next video, I'm going to go through the whole mechanism of Hofmann rearrangement so you guys know exactly what to expect.